Election day starts in about 8 hours, and I am very apprehensive. We've been talking about a blue wave or blue tsunami for several months, and all indications are that things should turn out okay, but I just been there before, and I'm really concerned that things are not going to go well. But of all the things that have come up that people have argued about that have me worried the most are the number of people on the left who seem to feel disaffected, that don't seem to think that voting matters. It doesn't matter whether they're Democrats or Republicans hold power in the House and the Senate. And I have to say that makes me feel pretty forlorn. And I've tried to make the argument to people that it does matter and point to what's been going on, not just the last 2 years, but what's going on for quite a while, but especially the last 2 years with Trump in office. And I've tried to make the argument that, we're losing a lot of ground. If you're on the political left, and it doesn't matter how much on the political left you are, whether it's a little bit or a lot, there's a lot going on. It's easy to see all the crazy stuff that Trump tries to do, or at least talks about doing. But while we're all focusing on that, House and Senate Republicans, continue to cut taxes for the people with the most money. The 1%, the 0.1%. They keep rolling back environmental laws. They keep trying to pass laws, both in the federal level and the state level, that hurt, minorities, hurt women, hurt LGBTQ community, and they're packing all the courts with far right wing judges. And the thing is, there's always been a problem when it comes to fighting the right wing, because even though that they are never the majority in the country, they're very good at getting their people to get together and vote, even if they're not particularly keen about one party or one candidate or another, I should say. And that's never really been the case in the left. And there's always been, I guess, in part because there's more diversity of thought, that it's more difficult to bring people together. And that's to be expected to a degree, but I think that some people just don't see things as urgently as I do. And the thing that scares me about that is I expected things would be bad these 2 years under Trump, but they've actually been worse than I predicted. And that's the really scary part. I know people speak in very apocalyptic terms all the time, and in our culture in general, we have a tendency to use really extreme language. We've reached the point where, even mundane things get called, referred to with extreme language. So sometimes it can kind of numb us to when something really extreme is going on. But so I have to wonder, people who look at what's going on now, and I get if you're, I get it if you're on the right and you like what's happening. Okay, fair enough. I think that's horrible, but at least that's what you want. But for anybody who's on the other side of the fence, who thinks what's going on is bad, and we're watching decades, 80 plus years of left-wing progress being rolled up before our eyes, or worse yet, in the dark, and yet there people don't feel a sense of urgency. They don't feel connected to it, and that's the thing I find hard to kind of understand. Part of it, obviously, the 2016 Democratic primary was very contentious, and I'm not looking to get into those arguments right now. Really, we're well past the time to try to litigate and relitigate that. What happened happened, and I'm going to disagree with a lot of people on their interpretation of what happened, but it doesn't really matter. We're here now, and we've had the Democratic primaries. And actually, progressive candidates did reasonably well. And that's what kind of scares me more. We've had Ocasio in New York, and a number of others, Lubita, Beto O'Rourke and Gillum and I forget the woman running in Georgia for governor, but she's certainly a more progressive candidate. And yet that still doesn't seem to kind of bring out any enthusiasm on the far left, even though that should be an indication that certainly that there's a path for progressives in the Democratic Party today. And I think if they win, if those candidates win, that will, breed even more because, success breeds, more success. People will see that result and then say, oh, well, maybe we can win with that message. Maybe not everywhere, but that would embolden people to want to move in that direction if they see that there's some success with that message. So I guess I reach a point where I'm kind of stymied. I don't know what else to say to people. If you care about LGBT rights and you see the attacks again, both federal and state, if you care about women's rights, you care about minority rights, you care about the environment, you care about worker rights, you care about immigration, and you're coming at any of these from the leftist perspective, the Democrats may be bland. And they're probably not going to give you everything you want, but I have a hard time understanding the idea that both parties are the same and you're going to get the same thing out of them. I mean, I don't think we would ever see the Democrats hide the data on climate change so that and make it so that they can't report it. They wouldn't tell the CDC that they couldn't report on gun violence. They wouldn't. They basically render the FDA and the EPA meaningless. I mean, they wouldn't hire. We used to have scientists in these roles, and now they're right wing hacks. The right wing is stacking the courts. Trump is stacking the courts. It's not just SCOTUS, although I assume anyone on the left would not be happy with either Gorsuch or Kavanaugh. The same thing's happening, down the circuit courts. So if you want Citizens United overturned, that's not going to happen. That's not going to happen for a generation because these positions, most of these positions are lifetime appointments. And so it seems to me, you'd want to try to stop that bleeding. If you care about protecting a woman's right to control her body, regarding abortion and other things, you'd want to stop that, take the out of the control of Republicans, take that away from them because it's clearly, they're not on your side on that. So I don't know what else to say, and I'm tired of fighting with people. It's really depressing that despite all the anti-Trump feeling, that doesn't seem to be enough to motivate enough people on the left. And if the Democrats don't do well, it's not just the Democrats losing. I've heard a few people say to me that, oh, well, the Democrats are for the status quo. And while I don't believe that that's an accurate representation, even if it was, if my choices are between stagnation and retrograde, I'm going to take stagnation because that's something, down the road I can fix. I can try to just because you vote for the Democrats doesn't mean that you have to just put up with whatever they do. You can protest them just as well as you protest the right wing, and try to hold their feet to the fire. And if I again, what's why would you think it doesn't matter? So I'm wondering, how, if you're a leftist, you don't have a dog in the fight. It's not about the Democrats winning or losing. It's not. It's about whether or not left-wing ideals will lose ground or not. Because here's an important thing to remember, and it's something that kind of came clear to me, and I've been trying to put these in words probably for years, but what comes right down to it is that individuals don't make laws. Groups of individuals do. So the individual candidates, they matter to a point, and certainly, in the primaries, that's the place really to try to get the best candidates that you can. But once the die is cast, you know, which group that is viable and has is likely to get any votes is the one that's going to do the best for you. And sometimes the best that you can do is to go nowhere. I think, although, again, I don't agree with that assessment that it would be going nowhere. Maybe not in all fronts, certainly. But, you know, the Republicans are hostile to pretty much everything that people on the left believe, and to the point now where it's simply because people on the left want it, they're against it. I swear, if we came out and said everyone should breathe, they'd all hold their breath. And I'm only slightly exaggerating. You know, if you just take a look at the coal rollers from a couple of years ago. So I don't know what else you want, people. I don't really care whether or not a candidate is exciting or not, whether they're sexy, you know, from a policy standpoint. You know, what motivates me are these issues and where I think we'll end up better off based on the available choices. Because voting third party currently is not going to result in any political action at all. And that's just a fact. And that's not good that that's the case. I agree with people that say that it's not good. I'm fine with, you know, trying to go to ranked choice voting or something like that. But the fact of the matter is we're not going to get any of that out of the Republicans. They're just not going to do that. You know, and I saw somebody that I know and used to respect that said that, you know, they're not going to take part, not until we get rid of the Electoral College and not until we have universal health care. Well, you know, those are two very laudable goals to have, but I fail to see how not voting is going to bring any of those around. You know, and I wanted to ask the person, well, what's your plan then? How do you, if you're not going to participate, under what means do you feel that we can, you know, have this accomplished? And look, if you got a way, if you got a better way, I'm more than willing to listen. But so far, all I hear about what people are not going to do, and very little about what their plan is for actual progress. So, you know, if you fancy yourself progressive, you know, key part of that word is progress. Retrograde is not progress. Stagnation is not progress either, but one's worse than the other. You know, and some people like to say, you know, the lesser of two evils is still evil, but my point is that the lesser of two evils is still less evil. So to me, that's enough motivation. I can't force anybody to vote or do the right thing, but I would hope that people would really be introspective and kind of look at it and see, well, what can we do today so that we have a better chance of doing better than that tomorrow? I don't see how losing more ground is going to help. So anyway, I hope you guys get out and vote. I hope we do get a blue wave. I hope we get a blue tsunami. I want to crush Trump's ability to do damage, because make no mistake, even if the Democrats, you know, win the House and the Senate, you know, there's still a lot of bad that Trump can do. And I'd like to stop that and stop losing the progress that so many people on the left have struggled for the last 80 years. So anyway, we'll see what happens tomorrow. Thanks.